From the data you just obtained, I've identified the location of a singularity. All right, Captain. Head for the singularity and transport the wormhole digger.
According to our projections, you'll be able to acquire from it the Iris energy needed to return home.
You're approaching the weight limit of what you can carry. At this rate, it'll impact your activities, so be careful. your stamina. You should rest before you're out of gas.
Attention to your I am recording this while observing the Wanderers from a distance. They are strange creatures, seemingly able to continue communicating even after losing their heads. I will never get used to it, no matter how many times I see it. Since we launched our investigation, the cameras in our drones have spotted numerous human-like metallic crystalline life forms. Basically, they are the organisms referred to as Wanderers by Warden Tier Section. Although we know that Wanderers are strange and unique organisms that take human hosts, we are yet to find any humans not already infested. Wanderers apparently got their name from their tendency to wander aimlessly about Dite until they come into contact with us. At present, the only thing we know about them is they are extremely sensitive to sound. Most Wanderers have poorly developed eyesight, but have offset that with hypersensitive hearing. Still, there is much that we do not know about their ecology. Naturally, we plan to continue our research until all of these questions are answered. Investigation Day 31. Our communications with headquarters have been unstable lately. It appears to be due to excessive wear on our communications equipment. We are consulting with the tech team as to the feasibility of procuring replacement parts. Failing that, we are likely to lose communications completely at some point. On the other hand, our research into the Wanderer's ecology... One thing we learned is that they seem to possess a shared consciousness. That would definitely explain everything we observed so far. This was one of our most recent discoveries. We captured one and tried to take it back with us, but other nearby wanderers immediately began to converge on us, almost as if our prisoner had given off some kind of distress signal. As a result, we were able to come up with a hypothesis regarding this shared consciousness. The crystalline structures within the Wanderer's bodies appear to be made of Kuban energy. We've theorized that they use such energy to communicate with each other in a manner similar to the wormhole technology. With this hypothesis in mind, I would like to continue our investigation. There is one more thing I must mention. We have determined that the crystalline structures on the Wanderer's backs envelop the human brain at the point of contact and then solidify there. It may be that by destroying these crystals, we can stop the Wanderers from functioning. According to the research team, the most effective way of dealing with the Wanderers is to sneak up behind them and destroy the crystalline structure with a knife. I suppose, like any other living organism, they cannot function without a brain.